Hello, today's lecture is on the beauty of analysis. Something that I don't think people lecture on, but I think it's important to take the time and think about why we would even want to analyze anything. So remember what analyzing was and what analysis is. To analyze something means to look at it very closely, to look beyond the surface. So who analyzes? Who actually looks at things closely? Well, there's not a deep thinker who does not analyze. Every deep thinker does analyze. Analysis is done in many fields, not limited to just analyzing literature or any one field. People analyze art to find meaning. Scientists analyze to form theories. Readers analyze literature. Mathematicians analyze problems. Geologists analyze the world, economists analyze the economy, historians analyze history, sports coaches analyze plays, musicians analyze, writers analyze, politicians analyze, lawyers analyze, doctors analyze, filmmakers analyze, philosophers analyze, and on and on and on. Basically, anyone who thinks deeply analyzes. So you should analyze too. Do you need more convincing? Are you asking why should I analyze? The question really is, why would you not analyze? Not analyzing is very lame. To not analyze is to not look beyond the surface. You don't get to see all that hidden, beautiful stuff that lies just beyond the surface. It would be like looking at a lake, seeing the surface, and saying, I see the lake, it's just a lake, nothing else, whatever. When really, there's a whole new world down there. Full of fish. Heck, for all you know, the dang city of Atlantis could be down there. But you're not going to find it unless you analyze. If you don't analyze, you'd never know what was beyond the surface. You'd just be like boring water, whatever, when there's so much down there. So be an analyzer. You find beautiful things. Analyzing stories is pretty awesome too. We'll look more at how to analyze stories, but I want to just give you some examples of analyzing stories. It's really interesting to analyze great stories, including video games, movies, books, all of that, comic books. I won't eliminate any of that. Those are stories as well, and you can analyze them just as well as you analyze literature. You can get really deep into those stories. You could analyze Harry Potter forever if you're a Harry Potter fan. You know, Professor Lupin, his werewolf disease mirrors diseases such as HIV and AIDS in the non-magical world, and you could look very deeply into that and actually support those ideas with evidence. You could analyze Hunger Games. You could talk about forms of political oppression and revolt in the book, or anything else. There's a lot of themes in there. You could analyze the Portal video games. You could try and see how it comments on large corporations and trust. The cake is a lie. What does that mean? Heck, just the other day, I was looking deeper into parts of Holes. I noticed on page 23 that Derek Dunn, the bully at school, made Stanley miss his bus the day he was arrested. If Stanley hadn't missed the bus, he wouldn't have walked home. He wouldn't have gotten hit by the sneakers. He wouldn't have been arrested. So, if Derek Dunn didn't pick on Stanley that day, Stanley would have never gone to Camp Green Lake. Think about that. Thinking deep is like a game. You get better at it the more you do it. You learn tricks as you go along, and you can share great ideas with friends. So why would you not analyze? Be someone who looks beyond the surface.